Hi there, welcome back. Well, it's taken me quite a while to get to this stage, mostly because I couldn't get supplies. We're all on lockdown, but I think I'm there. The cabinet has been done. I'll show you the result in the end. It is not as good as I would have liked it to be. There were a few flaws on there that I just couldn't get out. And the reason is that this thing actually had a very, very thick layer of veneer. So thick, in fact, that I couldn't get down to the wood without actually damaging the base wood in the process. So I had to sort of improvise. And as I said, it's not my best work. I must admit that. But I might have to do this again when we get back to normal and I can get a proper sander. All the little extras have been done as well. Those plates have been polished. The logo, the side panels, these have got a new layer of, it's not quite felt, but it's good enough it's perfect for speakers. That rim around the side has been polished. The bottom plate, if you remember, that bottom cover was completely, well, was fairly rotten. So I covered it with aluminium foil, and it seems to be holding up pretty nicely. Cleaned up the electrostatic tweeters, de-rusted screws, and this guy's been cleaned as well as it can be. It got my usual bath with shaving foam, got its logo repolished. The back was cleaned up, as was the speaker. And finally, here she is, all dressed up, all painted up, looking absolutely beautiful. Let me give you a close-up and show you what the result is. All the brass really makes this thing pop. Piano keys look beautiful. They look like they came out of the factory yesterday. Everything's looking good, really good. If you recall, the switch wasn't working. It now is. The Magic Eye, I've put in a new Magic Eye, and I'll show you that when we do the test. All these work very well. Everything's been cleaned up, looks perfect. Same with this side. The little details make this thing look a lot better. This thing was completely blacked out, if you recall. So that was polished. The Grundig logo was polished as well. And the links in between, some of the paint had chipped off. It's a dark brown. So that was repainted to get back to the original. The grill cloth has still got a few marks on it, as you can probably tell. But nothing serious. It just gives it that slightly aged look, which is what this is. So I'm pretty happy with that. If you recall, there was a huge part of the cabinet here that had chipped away. Now what I'd normally do is I'd put some veneer in there, but because supplies are scarce, I can't get it. I can't get out of the house. I actually used wood filler. And then because the varnish was very, very dark, you can't tell. Unless you look really, really close, you just can't tell. So I'm pretty happy with that. These side grills had no chips on it. They were in perfect condition. The only thing I did is I changed the cloth on the inside just to clean it up. It was basically falling apart. So that's now looking great again. And as I said, I'm not 100% happy with this cabinet. If I had access to a hardware store, I'd probably have done a better job. I might have to take it out again and do some more polishing. But it's not bad at all. Not bad at all. It's a little bit dull. But we'll see how I feel when things open up again. But that's a nice result. I like it. Now the Bluetooth module, if you recall, I put a socket and plug on the supply section. I've also put one on the audio in. That female RCA goes to the back and connects up to the DIN input. So it's fairly easy to remove. And this is now going to go in probably on that piece of board over there. There you have the power supply. That's tied in so that the ground connection doesn't flap around. That metal ring you see is actually ground, chassis ground. So if it was loose, you could end up with a bit of a mishap. But it's looking good. I'm surprised that I got it into this condition. Electrostatic tweeters were cleaned up and put in there. Obviously, I've soldered the speakers and the electrostatic tweeters back to the output transformer. This is the sort of thing where you've got to be careful. Make sure you make notes of this because you don't want to connect it the wrong way around. One of them's got B plus on there. And this is the result. The only thing we need to do next is test it, and that's what we will do.
Avec tellement copier-coller. Il y a des sens. On peut dire des choses avec nos mots. Regarde, nous avons par exemple 100 mots.
Entre vous, sur le fond, et la période ne s'y prête pas. On ne peut pas nier ni votre grande souffrance ni celle de votre fille. Ce n'est sûrement pas.
Buenas tardes, mañana se cumplen 100 días desde que China notificó la neumonía de origen incierto que hoy conocemos como la COVID-19. Hoy en la... ...a la clase política.
No es verdad que se acerca de 15.000 muertos, no. La semana pasada, menos positivos diagnosticados.
Even to the one who is crucifying him, he does not cross, but allows himself to be.
Marekani na Uingereza zikiripoti idadi ya juu ya vifo.
Victor Onara.
Ave, mama is.
وإن تعرف
كرشان رنجاد الناس
تفرح من بريطانيا بوز جنس
أولئك من المؤمنين
Porque según las últimas cifras,
Haití ha superado los 6.800 contagiados. Tomado porque si es a juicio de
When she bought those few things from abroad, there can be no equality or mutual benefit for a country that does not strive to become self-reliant.
Remember that old scene.
Mao was extremely busy in the days following that visit to the...
Situação que deixa o Presidente da Câmara ainda mais preocupado, porque só no seu concelho estão 1.200 pessoas na espera de testes. Marco Martins Faz as contas, admito que nesta altura haverá mais de 300 infectados em Gondomar que ainda não sabem que estão.
E em Gondomar o número é este. Há mais de 1.200 testes prescritos que as pessoas estão à espera. Como é que está a resposta de 40 por dia, nem daqui a um mês e meio conseguimos testar as pessoas que hoje precisam, para além daquelas que nos próximos dias infelizmente irão acrescentar.
Estava a dizer que há 1.200 pessoas à espera de fazer testes?
É só em Gondomar, sim.
Isto pode significar também que os números podem não ser reais.
Nestes períodos, tradicionalmente, locais de destino.
A Operação Páscoa começa às 0 horas de amanhã e prolonga-se até ao próximo domingo. O número de cuidados intensivos está a estabilizar. Este é um dos dados do boletim.
Autorização para consumo.
De 22, conhecido pela sua obra lírica, de onde se destaca a zarzuela A Cor do Faraó, de 1910. Aos 13 anos, compôs a sua primeira obra, Dixit Dominus, para...
Preciso manifestar a intenção de fazer o pagamento dessa dívida, para isso entregar então uma declaração. Há ainda de condições de acesso no caso de quem recorre.
Há um mecanismo de layoff, dando um empréstimo no banco, através da declaração que é na Segurança Social. Para as empresas. Há um mecanismo de layoff, será limitado a 40% da massa de contribuições da taxa social única.
Well, that's about it. The reception tests have been done. Reception's pretty good, actually. I'm still a little bit disappointed about not having been able to complete this cabinet exactly the way I wanted to, but I guess that gives me a project for the future. Well, I want to thank you all for following me along on this journey. If you have, and if you've enjoyed this, please click like, share, subscribe, and all that jazz. Stay safe. And if you want to support the channel, you can do so on Patreon. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.